Hello everyone, I am Sonali Nawle, Assistant Professor of Computer Engineering Department of All India Shri Shivaji Memorial Society's Institute of Information Technology, Pune. Today our topic is Application Layer Protocols. In that we have to study about the HTTP and DNS protocol. HTTP is nothing but the Hypertext Transfer Protocol and DNS is nothing but the Domain Name System Protocol. HTTP is nothing but the hypertext transfer protocol, and in that protocol can be used to transfer the data in the form of plain text, hypertext, audio, video, and so on. It is a protocol used to access the data on the world wide web, that is www, and in this protocol is also known as hypertext transfer protocol because of its efficiency that allows to use in a hypertext environment where there are rapid jumps from one document to another document. And HTTP is similar to FTP, that is file transfer protocol, as it also transfers the file from one host to another host. But HTTP is simpler than FTP, as HTTP uses only one connection, that is no control connection or to transfer the files. The HTTP is used to carry the data in the form of MIME like format. Also, HTTP is similar to SMTP. As the data is transferred between client and server, the HTTP differs from the SMTP in the way the messages are sent from client to server and from server to client. SMTP messages are stored and forward while HTTP messages are delivered immediately. Then in HTTP protocol, there are several features. First one is the HTTP is a connectionless protocol. HTTP is a connectionless protocol, that is HTTP client initiates a request and wait for response from the server. When the server receives the request, the server processes the request and send back the response to the HTTP client, after which the client disconnects the connection. The connection between client and server exists only during the current request and response time only. Then second feature is the HTTP is a media independent. HTTP protocol is a media independent. As data can be sent as long as both the client and server know how to handle the data content. It is required for both the client and server to specify the content type in MIME type header. And third feature is the stateless. HTTP is a stateless protocol, as both the client and server know each other only during the current request. Then next is the HTTP transaction. Given figure shows that the HTTP transaction between client and server, the client initiates a transaction by sending the request message to the server. The server replies to the request message by sending a response message or acknowledgement. Then next is the messages. HTTP messages are two types. First one is the request message and next is the response message. Both the message type follow the same message format. That is first request message. The request message is sent by the client that consists of request line, then headers, and sometimes a body. And the response message is sent by the server to the client that consists of status line, header, and sometimes a body. Then next protocol is the DNS, that is Domain Name System. In that the domain name system protocol helps internet user and network devices discover websites using human readable host names instead of numeric IP addresses. The DNS is the phone book of the internet, and humans access the information online through domain names like suppose example.com. Then web browsers interact through internet protocol addresses, and DNS translate domain name to IP addresses. So browser can load internet resources. Then next is the there are three types of DNS. First one is the primary servers, then secondary servers, and caching servers. Then next is the figure shows that DNS is a TCP IP protocol used on different platforms. The domain name space is divided into three different sections. First one is the generic domain, then country domains, and inverse domain. In that generic domain means it defines the register hosts according to their generic behavior, and each node in a tree defines the domain name, which is an index to the DNS database. It uses three characters labels, and these labels describe the organization type. Then second one is the country domain. The format of country domain is same as a generic domain, but uses two character country observation. Then in place of three character organizational observations, abbreviations. For example, for the United States, US is there. Then next is the inverse domain. The inverse domain is used for mapping an address to a name. When the server has received a request from the client, the server contains the file of only authorized client to determine whether the client is on the authorized list or not. It sends query to the DNS server and asks for mapping an address to the name. Then working of DNS. DNS is a client-server network communication protocol, and DNS client send request to the server while DNS server send response to the client. Then client request contain a name which is covered into a IP address known as forward DNS lookups, while request containing an IP address which is converted into a name known as reverse domain name system lookups. Then domain name system implements a distributed database to store the name of the all hosts available on the internet. And if a client like a web browser send a request containing a host name, then a piece of software such as DNS resolver send a request to the DNS server to obtain the IP address of a host name. If DNS server does not contain the IP address associated with the host name, then it forwards the request to another DNS server. If IP address has arrived at the resolver, which is turn complete the request over the internet protocol. That's all about the DNS. Thank you.